Hi, it's Alexis Hasselberger, time management and productivity coach. Habits are hard, and I bet that you might be trying to build some new ones around this time of year, typically about around the beginning of the year. That's when we're trying to, you know, work out some new habits for the year, et cetera. But it's really, really hard, and it takes longer than we think. And willpower, motivation, they are just not enough to help us form those habits. And so we need to really think about what strategies we want to use that are going to help us get there without, you know, feeling bad about ourselves, because willpower just isn't enough. We don't need to feel bad about ourselves about that, because, you know, it just isn't. It isn't enough. So I want to provide some strategies to help you to form habits in a way that doesn't leave you trying to rely on your willpower or your motivation to make it happen. But first, I want to talk a little bit about, you know, how long does it actually take to build a habit? You may have heard this totally BS stat out there that it takes 21 days to build a habit. This is just not true. It was, you know, based on one tiny little study. It was really it's kind of an interesting thing about people who had limbs amputated or surgery and how long it took them to get used to their new face in the mirror or their new, you know, new body in the mirror. And that's just not what most habits are. And so there's actually a lot of other science that shows us some more, you know, interesting and realistic data about how long it really takes. So how long does it take? Somewhere between 3 weeks and 9 months to build a habit, with the average being 66 days or about 2 months. So, you know, a little over 2 months, that's actually three times longer than that 21 days stat. So if you're expecting yourself to build a habit in 21 days, times that by three, because that's the more likely probability of how long it's actually going to take. Now, hopefully that makes you feel a little bit better about things, right? It's not that you've failed before. It's just that you haven't given yourself quite enough time, right? All right, so what types of strategies can we actually use to help make sure that we are building these habits in a way that's sustainable and in a way where science is actually going to be on our side and helping us? A few different strategies you can use. Not all of them will work for you. You know, we're all different. We all have different brains. But there might be one or two in here that you're like, ah, that could work for me. And I want you to give that a try if you're trying to build a new habit. So the first one is this habit strategy of convenience. And this one actually works really well for most people. This is that if you're trying to build a habit, you want to make it as convenient as possible to do it. So let's just say you're trying to exercise more and you're going to run. You're going to run every day, or maybe three times a week, right? What you want to do is, how can you make that more convenient? Well, you know, putting your exercise clothes and your running shoes right next to your bed if you're trying to run in the morning, getting that all ready so that there's very little that you need to do. You know, for me, I do run, and, you know, hence the example. Something that I do on the weekends is I put on my running clothes first thing in the morning. And that way, if I have 20 minutes, I can just run. I can just go for a run, or I can run my errands, or whatever it is. I can actually just go run without having to say, oh, okay, well, I need 5 minutes to get changed and, you know, let me find my clothes, et cetera. Just make it as convenient as possible. Now, another strategy that you can try is a strategy of stacking. And this is a strategy where you take a habit that you already have strongly held, like, let's say, brushing your teeth, right? Something you do every day. Most people do it twice a day, or we hope. And then you attach another strategy to that, habit that you're trying to form to that strategy, right? And to that time that you're doing. So you're already brushing your teeth. That's part of an automated behavior in terms of your habit loop. And so you're going to say, take vitamins. You're going to take them at the same time as you're brushing your teeth, right? You're going to maybe store them right next to your toothbrush. That's convenience. And then you're going to just add that taking the vitamins directly onto brushing your teeth. You already brush your teeth, so it's not a big leap to add something in time to that. That's stacking. Now, another strategy that sounds kind of similar at first, but is a little bit different, is the strategy of pairing. And pairing is when we take something that we don't really want to do. So it's a habit we're trying to build, but, you know, maybe it's a little harder for us. We feel like we should do it because it'd be good for us, but it's not maybe something we enjoy yet. And we pair that with something we really enjoy. And so this strategy you often see showing up in terms of exercise at the gym, let's say, where you're going to say, you know what, I'm trying to exercise more. So I'm only going to allow myself to watch my favorite TV show when I'm on the treadmill, right? So we're pairing something that we want to be doing with something that we already enjoy doing. It's kind of like a little reward in the moment. Right. Or one I use all the time is, I don't really like cleaning at all. I don't like tidying up, but I do love listening to podcasts. So I will always put podcasts on while I am cleaning up. And that helps me to be able to, build that habit of cleaning more often, which is something I don't like to do, by making sure that it's more pleasurable in doing the thing that I like, which is listening to these podcasts. Now, moving on, we have a couple more strategies. One of them is streaks. So, you know, this is something you may be familiar with many apps like Snapchat or Duolingo, lots of different apps trying to get you to log in every single day. They don't want you to break the streak, right? And this is kind of this weird thing about human nature. We don't want to break the streak. And so you can actually apply this to yourself and habits that you want to build. If you're someone to whom, you know, not breaking the streak is something that, you know, feels like you want to do that, then go ahead and use a habit tracker. So if you're using TickTick for your tasks, there's a built-in habit tracker. If you don't have a habit tracker and you want an app for that, Habit Bowl is a great one that is free. Or you can use, you know, old school methods. You can use your journal to keep track of it. You can write it down. You can use a wall calendar and just kind of cross it off every day you do the thing. This type of strategy about don't break the streak or don't break the chain, it works much better with things you're trying to do daily, right? So maybe you're trying to meditate for a few minutes a day, or maybe you're trying to get in 10,000 steps a day or something like that. This is a strategy that can work a little bit better for those daily things so that you don't see that prick. And then finally, there's a very practical strategy, which is one that tends to work pretty well, and that is to simply add the thing that you're trying to do to your task list or to your calendar. So when you add it to your task list, it helps you make sure that you have, you know, a memory aid in there, that you're not just forgetting about it. You also get that little dopamine hit when you check it off the list. And then adding it to your calendar makes sure that you can actually account for the time that it's going to take. So, you know, if you're trying to exercise more, you're not just going to find the time to make that happen. You know, you're not going to just somehow find this, you know, extra 45 minutes in the day. You got to make the time to make it happen. And so by putting it on your calendar of when it's going to happen, you're both making sure to block out that time so you have enough time, and it's showing up on your calendar, which is something that you're already used to showing up for. So things that take time, like maybe cooking from scratch or packing your lunch or something like that, that you want to be starting to do, maybe a healthier habit, if you actually put the time on your calendar, that ensures that one, you have the time to do it, and two, you're getting a little calendar reminder that shows up when you're supposed to be doing it. It just makes things a little bit easier. So if you are trying to build some new habits this year, try out one or two of these strategies. You know, I don't know which ones will work for you, probably not all of them, but you know, at least one or two will. And so experiment, try it out, see what works and what doesn't, tweak them as you go along. And if one strategy doesn't work that well, try a different strategy. But remember, it's going to take a little bit longer than you think to build those habits. That 21 days thing, it's not really real. So expect yourself to take a couple of months of concerted effort to build a new habit, apply some of these strategies so that you don't have to feel like you have to rely on willpower or on motivation alone. And hopefully this will get you towards those new habits just a little bit sooner than you thought and with a little bit less effort.
Hey guys, it's Aries. I'm editing this video and I just want to quickly tell you to subscribe, since only about 87% of people that watch our videos are actually subscribed. So just scroll down and subscribe. It would be a huge help.